Okay. What's up, YouTube squad? Welcome to my channel. YouTube, hashtag YouTube can be great. Go ahead and follow my Instagram page because I do post announcements on what videos I'm gonna do and promotions and giveaways and stuff like that. The channel is YouTube_GR8_channel. Some of you already followed. Thank you very much. You guys are getting the news I'm posting. Rest of you, go ahead and join. Today, I'm gonna talk about Armon Wiggins. Somebody inboxed me and said, hey, why don't you go look at the Armon Wiggins show and see what he did? And he titled it Monkey Business, and he wanted to talk about this whole Evan Lozada calling OG monkey thing. And I already talked about colorism with Jason Lee, so I'm thinking to myself, no, I don't know if I want to watch this and shit. But then I end up watching it because you guys, subscribers, suggested I go watch it for a reason. I saw it and I'm just like, what the hell? Like, as I was listening to it, I felt like my IQ was dropping with each word that he was saying. Let me tell you some of the things that he said. He said Evelyn didn't mean it literally with the monkey, like with the, she didn't mean it literally when she said that OG was a monkey. He said the whole monkey business is attributed to the underdog syndrome, meaning basically like we all, the people who are saying that this was an incorrect act, this was an incorrect thing for her to say, is because we perceive OG as the underdog of the show. That we also, if that's not the case, we're looking at her and we're relating to her because we as black people may have been used to being called names and being talked about, saying that we have, you know, all these racial categorizations that then we relate to her, so that's why we feel the way that we feel. Well, Royce was an underdog, Keisha was an underdog, Mika was an underdog. This show has not been to the point where they would have boycotted in 8 seasons up till this situation has occurred. So when you sit there, Armon, and you say stupid ass shit like this, I don't know how you have the platform you have, you can say the stuff that you say. But he went on by saying that this is happening because she's not, that OG's not attractive and that he finds her ugly too. And that he thinks that if he saw her, he's gonna call her ugly too. I said, it's one thing to call somebody ugly, it's another thing to dehumanize them. You over here making the distinction that it is okay to call OG, a dark-skinned girl on TV, monkey when everybody's watching it. As a, why can't she just say she was ugly? Why she had to go that far? What's wrong? If you think she's ugly, it's fine. You don't have to think somebody's attractive to insult them. You can still say other things other than that. For you to sit up here and say that that's okay, I don't know what's wrong with you. To me, you are a traitor. How the hell can you even say what you just came out of your mouth? I'm not done yet. This is what he said. He's been watching the show like the rest of us, and he said that he calls people not only ugly, but he also refers to people as rats. If he sees somebody who has buck teeth, he'll say it. If he sees somebody who has nappy head, buck teeth, nappy head, monkeys, all that fall into the same stereotypical category, bruh. Like, what the hell? And he kept going. He said people say he looked like Dave Chappelle and that he didn't take that as a compliment because Dave Chappelle is not attracted to him. Okay, well, say he's not attractive, not a monkey. Then he moved on by saying that the point of depicting black people as monkeys is just like, we're just over-exaggerating at this point. And I'm sitting here thinking to myself, fool, when we look at anybody, not just black people, because black people are the ones that have been distinctively dehumanized historically. And the reason they do that is because they want to find some kind of way to inferior, to look them as an inferior race, or look at them as inferior. That way they can treat them the way that they've been treating them this entire time. So for you to say, no, oh, she didn't mean it that way. This is the problem with black folks. We are our worst enemies in every way. We are our worst enemies because we have people like Armon or Armon, whatever his name is, that will go and justify ignorant behavior and or minimize it and say, oh, it wasn't meant this way, it's just meant this way. We have not, some of us don't have, either we don't say anything, or when we do say something, we say the wrong thing, and people capitalize on that stupidity. And you're sitting up here feeding into that trap, and then you're following up by saying, well, I don't give a damn what anybody thinks, I don't care what they think, if they don't like it, they don't like it, but you disabled the comments so nobody will say anything to you. And you're sitting up here, you got more dislikes on this video than you have likes, which means you're doing something wrong. So why the hell are you perpetuating this narrative saying that you're right and you have this opinion is okay, so you don't have the ability to learn, you don't have the ability to grow, you don't have the ability, you just want to stay stagnant and not learn anything? Shut up. Now he went on to say that the historical aspect of it and what we say when we mention things like race, and when we talk about, when we relay the monkey thing to slavery, that there's no need for that, that is an exaggeration. Okay, well, let's go over some stereotypes in addition to monkey that have been said. Black women and black men have been saying that we have big lips, white nose, the girls have white hips, the cornrows, the big bust, these are defining defining characteristics that you see on a black person. And usually they did that during the slavery historical time because they wanted to say that black people were not attractive by genetic, they're not genetically attractive, they're ugly, they look like animals. And because they look like animals, according to their depiction, that nobody will want them. So it made sense for them to go and rape them and sleep with them because nobody wants them anyway, so they're a property. Why would you even, that understanding is literally like, what, went over your head? So you're saying that we shouldn't do that? And why is it that we don't talk about history? He said, oh no, relaying it to the past and talking about slavery, it's not about slavery, we shouldn't say that. Well, let me explain to you the importance of history, because you obviously didn't pay attention in class and you don't get it. Why is it that you sit in class and they even explain history to you? What's the purpose of it? Riddle me that. Let me explain to you the purpose of it. Because when you learn about the past, you're supposed to learn about the things that happen so you can rectify the present and make it better for the future of generations, your grandkids, your great-grandkids, and stuff like that. People who stay in the position that you are, in the mindset that you have, it is a form of slavery in your head, because subconsciously, you're refusing to progress. You're refusing to grow. And when I want to give you an example of what that means as it pertains to history, everybody knows about the Holocaust. We've heard about it in 1933. Hitler went and he basically butchered the Ashkenazi Jews with concentration camps, gas chambers, and starvation. This happened, right? We learned about it, and by the time he had murdered all of them, it was between 6 to 10 million people that had died due to his atrocities and what he did. What people don't talk about is that 24 years prior to this Holocaust happening, King Leopold of Belgium took his ass to Congo to colonize it. And while he was stealing the resources, for a span of 40 to 50 years, he butchered 15 million Congan people. But because they thought of them as animals, and because they thought of them as less than human, they looked at them as cattle, and people who were just there, he was cutting off hands, making them pick up diamonds and just butchering. He had a whole hut for raping the girls, and where the gorillas would just go and steal the little girls and rape. He completely just dehumanized them and treated them like crap, like he was like just crazy, and it killed 50 million of them, and nobody said anything. All the countries ignore them, and because they ignored them, 24 years later, you had the Holocaust happen. I guarantee you, if people talked about it and continue to talk about it, that situation that happened in Europe could have been avoided. But they ain't say shit, and they still don't teach that shit in history. And because people like you, obviously, you don't hear about it, and you don't crack up with a book. So you have this idea in your head that it's okay to say some of the ignorant shit that you just said. It's absurd that you would sit there with that platform, this big-ass microphone in front of you, and you would say something that doesn't give life to anybody. That doesn't give anything fruitful that somebody could use. You sit up there and you say something stupid. And let me give another example. The same Belgians went to Rwanda, separated the Tutsis, the Tuas, and the Hutus. Tutsis were 14% of the population. Hutus were 85% of the population. And Tuas were 1% of the population. What they did was they valued the Tutsis because they were lighter. They had thinner nose, according to them. They even went so far as to measure their damn skulls and said that because their skulls are wider, they're more intelligent than the Hutus. And because they programmed the Tutsis to think that way for generations, they actually started to believe that they were better. And they started mistreating their fellow black people so much so that by 1994, they had walked around with machines. The Hutus were so pissed off, hateful, and resentful that they murdered them. For you to sit here and make this asinine conviction that Evelyn saying that OG was a monkey is okay. Tell me how many people actually treat animals in the same caliber as they treat human beings. What do we do to animals? They're livestock. We have beef that we eat. We have chicken that we eat. We have goats that we eat. We have ducks. We have turkeys. We have fish. People eat them. They are sustenance. Their job is to provide for people. People who are not vegetarians and who are actually eating meat, they look at them as tools to provide sustenance. During slavery, when blacks were animals, they looked at them as sustenance to provide their lifestyle for them. And for you to sit here and say, oh, well, if I see somebody and I think they look like a monkey, I'm going to say they look like a monkey. Why don't you insult them a certain way? Why don't you say, you know what, you're so ugly, I don't want to see you. Get out of my line of sight, I don't want to look at you. You're hurting my eyes. Matter of fact, you're raping my face. I don't want to stare at you. Why don't you say that? If they're fat, tell them they need to just share their sandwich and not eat. Don't eat the whole thing. Share it with other people because your hefty ass is just, it's too big for you. Why don't you say stuff like that? If you think their breath stinks, why don't you offer them a toilet paper because mint's not going to fix it. Find other ways to insult people aside from focusing on the color of their skin. Imagine a world where we don't look at somebody based on what they look like, their complexion. What do you think might happen? The prison system will be different. The way that we treat people will be different. The poverty, the majority of brown folks are in a poverty type situation, living in that type of environment that gives you the knowledge that you have now, the ignorance that you have now, wouldn't be occurring to the magnitude that is occurring now. Seriously. Thank you so much for diverting me to watch this Wiggins show, because I took a look at it and I was just like, this has to be said, because a lot of people have been talking about it and I don't think that this asshole is really comprehending what we're saying. And I hope he sees this damn video, because he needs to understand what he's doing is wrong. You have all these people listening to you and this is what you're gonna say? Honestly, there are some people that don't need to be speaking on certain situations. You know, you just need to stay there and your silence is golden. Embrace that when it comes to colorism, when it comes to racism, because obviously you are lacking in the knowledge to be able to speak on something like this. And until you pick up a book, because apparently that's the biggest threat to you, is you lack the ability to go and have the consciousness to go and pick up a book and actually research shit before you open your mouth. So I don't feel bad about what I said. I hope you see this shit, because you said you don't give a damn what people think. So I don't give a damn about how you feel, because you need to educate yourself for real. Okay, guys, I'm so sorry. I had to just go ahead and do that real quick because he needed to know the truth. I did post the winner of this next giveaway on my Instagram page. Go and take a look at it, please. And if it's you, inbox me so I can go ahead and coordinate how to get that to you. Thank you so much. Like and subscribe. And make sure that you watch my next video, because apparently, y'all, Byron Scott's ex-wife, Anita, it's going to be on the next Basketball Wives season. They are going to capitalize on all the Scott's family's drama, and I'm going to talk about it. Let you know all the details and what's happening. Thank you. Bye.